Good hobbies that are with us again, we'll start with some easy things, color the life, and color changes, radio, and all that, and so on. So, the last point here is workflow related changes. I picked a few news from the last release that I particularly like. Everything is about what's new in 6.1. So first of all, the Smart is in previous release, it's updated to color palette. In 4.3 we had a mixture of two palettes as our standard.
Takes always the first slide from the template, which is the title slide.
right background. A strong background makes no sense. So you need to have some brighter gradients as well. It's also a good design, and that's what we change with some gray backgrounds. A completely different topic is draw styles. Styles in competitors are presented in a way that you can just select one of the styles and apply it to your application. Your draw style is difficult. It's kind of a gradient. So using a little bit of background as a color which starts with a bright red and goes to a saturated dark red. And our draw styles are mostly texture. We have objectless arrow, objectless no fill, and no fill, and all these things. It was not really a style, drawing style that could be applied. What we did is to create 8 new styles. It is from top fill, blue fill, green, red, and yellow. It's the same colors as just an outline and non filled background. What you can do is to apply these styles to your shapes, to your objects, and to get the hopefully really nice clearance. And because the spot is also about the future, this has changed. We remove many of the primarily textural drawing styles. Draw is also supposed to be a tool to create the presentation. Posters or some kind of more textual things. And since we removed it, there was a request to reintroduce some of the styles, and that has been done recently and will be available in the 6.2 release. It has a text section with 2 subsections for different sizes, A0 and A4, and 3 different texts that you can apply to your presentation. Something to print out. We put a lot of work into icon scenes. You may have heard the Polybre thing. Polybre is based on the idea that Windows has a server style which does not fit into Tango, Galaxy, Oxygen. Appears Linux was in the past where we got our from. So what has been done is to create a complete new icon scene with all the 3,700 icons, completely new. And this one is very well accepted by the Windows users. So what we also did, because we have to maintain it as our default, if you don't install any icons, you fall back again. Icons. The icon scene on top, the color is accidentally in black here, it should be white. The background should be different. And probably that means the icon scene on top is Parasa Jaga. It is work for future, some interesting work. It is a replacement for Oxygen, or it is inspired by Oxygen and tend to be a replacement. These 2 things have been added to our installation, and we remove high contrast industrial Oxygen because there's no maintainer, because it is outdated, and because the style does not fit into any system. When we talk about icons, we have also some application icons that are absolutely awesome. But the look and feel has changed the last years, and everything is rather flat and some kind of difference, some 3D appearance. So what we did is to make it flat and to apply the exact color from our color. details of the icons and break slightly adapted to the user. And now this always means that local bars are going to provide means to have more options to customize the interactions of the program. And the example that I had here is the top bar. It might not look too appealing to you, but it depends a lot on the system scene, how the horizontal, the vertical rulers look. These rulers are very hard. There was a screenshot on my system. If you take a different scene on your Linux system or if you're using Microsoft, it might be better. We're still working on it. It is still experimental mode. It lies on accessibility. You cannot use keyboard to step through the items, and on some points it has no contextual dependency. It switches to the right items on the notebook bar, but we are in the hope to get it fixed for 6.2. Not too optimistic that it is done, but the hope sign lasts. At least what he did is slightly prepared the variants of the notebook that we want to ship in the program as fast as possible. And last but not least, I made a couple of selections. What is nice from the UX point of view, the workflow. First of all, we modified a little bit the menus. Biggest change is that it's 6.0. I guess if I remember correctly, a new menu item is introduced, styles. You can go to the main menu, select one of the styles. And then this selection, we do have this style available. So get a new way to apply style to your document. It is also some kind of pedagogic argument that users should use styles rather than direct formatting, and we bring them into this by presenting a few features in a more prominent position. The next one is spell out chapter numbering. You can label chapters this clear text, first, second, third. It is even translated. I think it is a great addition to the Office. It's a nice feature and can be used in various places. I can like it. In Help, we have the opportunity to color types of information. The formula has a certain color, values have a special color and text. This is an example here. And what was missing is customization of the color. So the user was restricted to the predefined color. Now it's possible to customize these aspects and you can adapt it to your background. For example, if you want to verve is a dark background with the color of your sheet is dark, you can now use bright colors, for example. And something without image, because it's more under the hood. There was a couple of annoying tooltips and tables. No one needs a tooltip, but you go into the table and to adjust the table color. It's pretty clear. So some of these things were removed. The tooltips always pop up. You moved the mouse over the table, it was just destructive. Moved it. We had also, we still had a couple of really strange functions, strange ones. It is a timer that was started. You remove a column or a row in a table, write a table, you remove a column. You start a column, then you can use the keyboard to repeat the action and delete the next column this totally strange workflow is not really done learning. Problem was that the shortcut to run the actual command is how to convert it down to this function that is not known, not really well described, and actually no one knows it. So the request was to free the shortcut. That's why we removed the functionality from the program to make it more cleaner. And last but not least, tooltips for track changers is also something which is mostly distracting. You go over a document with track changers show, then you get a tooltip by whom the change was done and at what time of day. It is sometimes interesting, but if you're working in the document, you don't want always to know the same person can get the document back from one person. You don't want to repeatedly know that the same person at the same time changed something in the document. So what has been done? We introduced a function, an option to disable these tools. Tools, options, track changers, and there's a option you can disable these tools. Maybe also the toolbar. All these are done by several persons, definitely not by me, so the kudos goes to all members of the UX team as well to all the developers who were involved in these changes, and all I can say is thanks a lot.
Thank you.